It's funny that you ask. Well, maybe not funny, but interesting. Because only a few days ago I was reminded of my first encounter with the works of Poe. I was in third or fourth grade, so it must have been either 8 or 9. And we were reading The Telltale Heart, in a German translation, of course. Or maybe it was read to us. I can't quite remember. I don't even know if we were actually told the name of the author. Well, we probably were. But if so, that information obviously went straight into one ear and out of the other. Because even back then, I had no interest in people. However, I only mention this because even though I did not care who the author was, the story itself, or rather images that it created in my head, they left a deep impression on me, and I was strangely attracted to the story. I felt there was an enormous power behind it. But since I was young, I didn't really understand the connection. I didn't know why I felt the way I felt. The images, however, that were conjured up that day, they never left me. I still remember them. So flash forward a few years. At the age of 12, when my depression started to become heavier, and I thought of suicide as an option for the first time, and sort of gradually drew the cloak of darkness around me, if you wish, and slowly descended into the world of shadows. And in the course of that, I try to find solace in the world of classical, fantastic literature. And you cannot imagine my relief. That sense of destiny, if you wish. When I discover that someone I had already encountered had actually been waiting for me there all the time. Would Poe be the perfect reflection of your soul? You know, this may be an embarrassing thing to admit, but honestly, I have no idea how right you are. When I began to work on Poetica, I approached the poems from the outside. If you know what I mean. You know, I met them like old friends or acquaintances, ghosts I had already encountered in the past. But when the album was completed, and that's actually the embarrassing part, I had completely forgotten that those words had originally been written by a different person. I felt like they were my own. I had made them my own. In fact, they felt more like sopa than sopa did. If that makes any sense to you. So I didn't just adapt them to music. I adapted them to myself. There is a sound, a sort of funeral whistling that comes awful in your music, especially since Children of the Corn, for instance, on Dreamland, or The Wonderful, The Haunted Palace. Oh, thank you. It makes me think of old horror movies. Are those movies getting a growing influence in your work? I know what you mean. That's the old theremin. The sound is almost synonymous with old black and white science fiction horror movies, yes. It's a sort of instrument you literally expect to hear when you think of these films. And I can't deny that I'm actually very fond of it. I've always been. It suits me perfectly. Aside from the oh-so-eerie atmosphere creates, it's also a lovely bridge between the coldness of the synthesizer and the warmth of the violins. It combines and balances the extremes, and that's what I'm all about. Do you like the movie The Oblong Box with Vincent Price and Christopher Lee? That's the only Poe story that you interpret, which is not a poem but a story. Oh. To be honest, I can't remember it. I know that I've watched it, but it obviously didn't leave an impression on me, otherwise, I would remember it. Unlike Roger Corman's adaptation of The Fall of the House of Usher, also with the divine Vincent Price in dark velvet and bleached hair, and generally divine and beautiful and breathtaking. In fact, I would go so far as to say that that is my favourite Poe adaptation. That one definitely had a lasting impression on me. To this very day.